news coverage, maybe that's the best way to put this, around this. I've been trying to follow everything, but if you can clarify for me that, so you're saying that the report by the Attorney General did indeed find that some remains went to landfills, is that correct?
Chairman Gonzalez and Representative Ranking Member Antonio, yes, according to our communication with the Attorney General's office, those were the findings as a result of the investigation.
Follow Representative Antonio, in my understanding is that so the original disposal and directions and information for that actually goes back about 4 years to 1975. I'm looking at some information that has a citation of how human disposal is done. And so just again for clarification, so this bill would indeed change the way the disposal process is done, correct?
The intent of our bill is to clarify and define humane disposition. And that would be the, and whether that affects the disposal, the way the remains, fetal remains are currently disposed, probably, I would assume, I don't have the information that you're referring to, but probably yes, it would inevitably change that. But in the effort to, again, define humane, we felt clarification was necessary as a result of the investigation.
Representative Antonio, thank you. And so ultimately, is it that the remains are disposed of by incineration? I'm just trying to understand it. And can you also explain the additional language for hospitals and what the intent of that is?
Through the chairwoman to Ranking Member Antonio. So really what we're looking at doing in this case is as the representative said, further and clarify what we anticipate the humane disposal is. And so what we're saying is we're looking at burial, cremation, and that matches up with what we already do with hospitals, particularly when the child that is being aborted is 20 weeks or more, or a baby is lost at 20 weeks or more, I guess I should really say, that the hospitals are offering the opportunity to do the burial cremation. So this just really tags into something that's already out there. The idea of using the hospital-type incinerator, that was some language that LSC picked up, because in days ago, the hospitals used to have their own incinerators. So you would look at that as a common definition, so you're not recreating something different. Now it's our understanding through conversation with the hospital association that there are no incinerators in facilities anymore, that they are all outsourced to professionals who deal with this. So what we're saying is that when a facility that performs abortions, when they outsource the remains, that it needs to go to an incinerator that has been approved. And that way we know what's happening with it. So, and it'll be essentially the same whether it's a hospital facility or whether it's an independent freestanding facility. Again, let's find some commonality and a definition so we're not being unclear of the level of expectation.
And Representative, thank you. And so I'm guessing that as we talk about this bill more, that the definitions of what an approved facility is and what approved procedures are will come to light, I'm assuming. And will this also apply? So right now, you've discussed this morning, this afternoon, almost, but not quite this evening. you've discussed the fetal remains from an abortion. Would these same rules apply if someone is hospitalized because of miscarriage?
Through the representative to the ranking member. So this piece of legislation very specifically relates only to abortions. So this does not relate to a miscarriage. So this piece of legislation, very very specifically on line 8, says it shall adopt rules related to abortions. So in this case, we're not talking about a miscarriage. We do know, however, that we have other legislation on the books, our other laws already on the books that discuss a miscarriage or a stillborn over the age of 20 weeks, where the hospital will then allow a parent to have a burial or cremation if a death certificate is also issued. So we're not looking to discuss the miscarriage.
Thank you. I'm confused because we're talking about fetal remains, and so I'm confused as to why we make a distinction as to how that ended up happening, because we're talking about biological remains. We're talking about, I don't understand why there's a distinction, because my understanding of your bill was we're talking about a humane disposal of these remains. What does it matter how it happened if the focus is really on the remains and what we do and how we humanely dispose of those remains? So can you put it up?
Through the chairwoman to the representative. So right now, if you're in a hospital setting and you were to miscarriage, it is my understanding that any remains that are captured are disposed of in a way that is by the rules and regulations that the hospital has to comply with through the Department of Health and the other regulatory agencies that are over the Department of Health. So this really creates a scenario where we're really having parity, not distinction, between a facility and a hospital. So this creates a common platform for how we're creating a definition, which was one of the highlights that the Attorney General pointed out, was that we didn't have that in his report, that we were leaving that definition too open-ended, potentially. These are my words, not his. And therefore, this is simply more clearly identifying a level of expectation on how we're going to be treating the remains. I don't know if you want to add to that at all.
No, I think that Chairwoman Gonzalez and Ranking Member Antonio, I think that she precisely and very well articulated the stance. But in our conversation with hospitals and the research that we have done before presenting this bill, what we have in a very unscientific study discovered is that the vast, vast majority of hospitals, and I would hesitate to put any type of percentage on this, dispose of any miscarriage remains, or if there has to be some type of an abortion procedure, in a manner where most of those are already sent to a funeral home and to a crematory. And so they are already abiding by voluntarily, but also in pursuit of those regulations that they're required to stand by.
Can I just one more? Yes, thank you. So at the end of the day, I mean, truly, while we're talking about the medical facilities, it seems to me, again, to clarify if I'm wrong, that what we're really talking about are regulating and standardizing, maybe for all of these cases, actually the groups that dispose of the remains, right? As you said, most of the medical facilities outsource. So we'd really be talking about those companies that outsource this, that they would be the ones then that would be uniformly disposing of the fetal remains.
Through the chairman to the member, I think that probably is a good way to look at it. We know just from hearing some of the conversations that have been in the press, at least I believe I read it in the press or I listened to it, was that the facilities that perform the abortions contract with the outside contractor, and they may say that you need to comply with all of the rules required by the state of Ohio, but they may not get granular enough to know exactly what that means at that company's end. And so we're simply clarifying it so now everybody knows where the level of expectation is. So the companies that provide the service now know what options they'll have when it comes to the incineration or the disposal. And my guess, when we get to rule writing, it'll work like often does, where the interested parties will sit down with the Department of Health, and they'll say, okay, let's look at the lay of the land, let's look at, you know, what's appropriate, what are our level of expectations, and, you know, to the extent that they would choose to participate, like any other interested party meeting, they'll be at the table having a conversation. But you are correct. If I have a facility that performs abortions here, and they contract out here, they may never have asked that final question because we weren't asking them to, and now we are.
For example,